Hello there, and I was thinking I was gonna make a little commentary video on how I did the world record, because thought it was interesting enough, and I've seen a couple people try to beat it, and they haven't done it yet, so here I am, and I'll just go through this like a bit by bit, kind of explain how it's done, just kind of talk about what went right and everything like that. So let's have a go here. Let's just look.
Okay.
So basically, what I did actually figure out is that the Ford Escort, the car I picked, is faster than the Golf, but it's harder to control because of its rear-wheel drive. But it is still a better car if you want to go for a good time. So this is New Zealand One, and this is the stage we've all practiced on the most. Like, even since now, I've shaved off about 10 seconds of time, almost 10 seconds since this. So, yeah. So I don't know how this was all right. I guess this was an okay stage. It went fine. It was a good start. Yeah, but I basically on this day I didn't figure I wouldn't make the record because, well, my previous time was about 5, what was it, 5 minutes? I don't actually know. I don't believe that 5:19 might be accurate. It could, yeah, it probably is. See, I missed a major cut here. I could have, you can easily just cut straight through this whole bit, but I just went around it a bit, and it was a mistake. Sometimes I forget about it, and this was a nice recovery right there. So, yeah, there's a couple of moments in this where there are some pretty pixel perfect like misses, and yeah, it's quite crazy. I feel like I got quite lucky some points. But I think this is more about anticipating the turns, yeah, and knowing where they are because of the screen crunch. There's no real way to react, so you just have to memorize where they are. So that's why we picked the Escort, because it's faster on the straights, and if you can get the handling down, then you're good. You can easily set better times. So I'd say on the other tracks, not so much this. The Golf is very good on here, but when it comes to places like, I don't know, Greece, it's better to use the Escort. You'll see why. So that's the first stage. It was a pretty good start. I was already 14 seconds ahead of my old time, and it was basically at that moment where I realized, yeah, this was definitely possible. It was certainly possible to make the record now, and I realized how much time I could be saving if I was driving as good as I was. It's a bit, obviously, it's a little bit optimistic, but it ends up coming true anyway. This is Greece 2. I mean, not Greece 2, this is New Zealand 2. New Zealand 2 is a bit more tricky. It's not as straightforward, and there are some couple technical bits, and there is a major cut point, but it's a lot of it. I think the cut point in this track has more to do with luck than skill. This one, you just have to get lucky at passing through. And this was a mistake. It happens a lot. We crash into the tree stump there. Obviously, maybe if I didn't crash in this tree stump, I would have saved a second. That's it, though. Yeah, when you have minor collisions like that, it doesn't use this. You don't waste a lot of time. Yeah, a lot of. It's also good to point out that the co-driver in this is not the best in the world. He doesn't put the best calls. He doesn't have them at the best time. So anyway, here's the cut. So it's a lot of it is down to timing and doing it well, and you have to go slow. Sometimes you'll hit nothing, and sometimes you'll usually end up hitting around 2 times. So that's normal. That's a pretty average cut, I guess. Yeah, there are some pretty nasty like bumps and corners. So it's very nice that the co-driver doesn't call out the small bumps, it doesn't call out the small little turns. So I mean, the good, sometimes he's pretty good at calling the big turns, but generally, when it comes to that, it's just not good. This was close. This was a close call right there. I just had to remember that there's a tone, so I didn't turn as much as I should, or as much as I was going to. It was good. And this is a nice crash point that the co-driver does not tell you about. Doesn't tell you about this turn. There are some spots where the game will catch you. And this was a small mistake. I thought the road went a little bit longer than it does. And there's a last hairpin. And then right away I was realizing we were really far ahead of time. We're 32 seconds now down. So I was like, wow, this is definitely gonna go good. This is not possible. So here we are. Now there's only two stages per country. Normally there's like four or six. Here only two. So the novice is a bit like a demo. Let's put it that way. So this is Greece. This is the fastest rally of them all, even in the main game, I would say. I mean, I don't know about the main game. I tried playing through the whole thing. Well, at least intermediate, that includes the UK and Australia. What else? There would be a Sweden, but there is no Sweden. What's the other one? I don't remember. So when it comes to this, both Greece 1 and 2 were very fast. I tried doing them again. Couldn't beat my records on them. So this was a very good 146 on both. Really good times on this. Some really close hits on the walls. Most people hit this wall. Generally, this was a good one. Really, smooth hairpins through there. And some decent angling and good timing on those turns. So that's what was this was a problem. The AI doesn't, the co-driver does not tell you about this turn. There's another decent. It could have gone that was a little like not smooth, delayed. Decent turn through there, but overall this was really good. Both this and the next stage. It was a really hard part in the next stage. You'll see when it's. This one well though. Yeah, 146. Your previous Greeces were pretty good, and this kind of shows that Greece all along was pretty good. It wasn't so much a hindrance to the run. It was mainly New Zealand and Austria. Austria is the difficult part. Austria is where you can make or break, because you can either do really well and beat everybody else, because everybody else is having trouble with it as well. Small mistake there. Yeah, little bumps on the sides there on when you hit the side of your car or the back. It's just a little, it doesn't cost you really anything. Very nice correction through there. There's some really good recovery points where you think you might crash, but then nice, very nice steering recovery. Yeah, pretty good turns through here. It's a good section, this one. Yeah, really well timed on the turns there. This was probably one of the main reasons. Just the timing on these turns. Not driving too far to the track. This is a good turn right here as well, really good. There's a major cut right there that I missed. So you can just go right through that and have a pretty much straight line up here instead of having to turn twice. Imagine you could save it. This is another horrible spot where you can easily just crash, and it's going to happen because, well, it's just one of those places. And this is the hard part where you have like stumps everywhere. You really have to keep on the road here. You go off road and you're probably going to crash into something and you'll stop. Yeah, so this is a tough part. And there's going to be a nice downturn. And then you're off to the finish. So this is pretty good. This was another great stage.
I'm gonna fucking die from a heart attack, idiot.
Yeah, so this is when... It was at this point when I realized, yeah, this is definitely going to be possible now. Because my summer best, was already 14:21. It was just 3 seconds off of CD's world record at this time. It still is the second place. Some guy tried to come along and beat, but I don't think he's actually beat CD's time yet. I think he's at 4:19. Maybe he's at 4:15 now, which makes him does make him second place. Also, thing I should point out, a couple things. When you go to Austria, you have to switch to wet tires. If you don't do that, you will have very bad traction on this, and it will cost you the run, most definitely. And the other thing is, well, now I don't remember that. God damn it. But yeah, the main point of Austria is the tire change, and getting used to it, because the car has less grip anyway. So you just, there's a lot of slow hairpin turns like this. It's everywhere, but it's kind of nice. If you can master those, you're gonna get a really good time on Austria 1. Yeah, really nice turns through here. Yeah, it's really working out this time. This was a nice correction. It could have been a disaster, but I ended up fixing it very quickly. Perhaps if you're driving... Oh, this was a nice mistake of mine. Perhaps if you're driving the Golf, you might actually end up doing better through here because the car has better handling. So you could actually do better in Austria, but I don't know about Greece and New Zealand, really. Maybe New Zealand, but not Greece. This was a hesitation. Yeah, very nice turn through there, just light taps. Yeah, a technique that I used during this was I would feather the gas a lot, and just keep the car not at max speed, but just try and keep it at a decent speed where you can still control it, but have good speed as well. That was the main thing. So even if you do make a mistake, you don't just fly off into a wall somewhere. So this was a good one, this was really good. Now we're all of a sudden 1:06 ahead of my previous. And it was basically at this point where I was like, yep, this is definitely happening now. You just need to keep yourself together for the last stage, and you'll be fine, and you'll make this record. There you do that. Well done. There's a small mistake there. There's some really nasty parts in Austria where you can just, like, get stuck in corners and stuck behind, like, walls of trees. It's just bad. But one thing I'd recommend if you're going to play this is please do not keep hitting the restart button over and over and over again, because see it? And when people just keep hitting the restart button over and over and over again to do the first stage or two good, this is a nasty turn, this one. There's a tree stump. If you can somehow get through this perfectly, then you're going to save a lot of time. But, yeah, the thing that I don't like seeing when I see people run this is stop resetting just because you mess up the first stage or two. You need to practice Greece, you need to practice Austria if you want to have a good time. Because if you have good Greece, good Austria, then you can beat my time. But if you just keep practicing New Zealand over and over and over, okay, fine, you'll beat me in New Zealand, but what about the rest? I had really, just really good runs on Greece and Austria. Surprisingly good. This is the easy part of Austria. It's hard to screw this up when you're on asphalt. You can just keep the grip going, and you need to make sure the car is on the track. Don't leave the track. Yeah, this is a decent correction. Very nice recovery through there. Could have been a lot worse. That's the thing, I just had full concentration mode and I was able to recover the car in very good time. That's one of the reasons I had a good run like this. This is it. This is the final. And that's it.
Oh, God, how good.
And that's it. That's the final. That's a very nice reaction there. And, yeah, that's basically it. I don't know. This was a very good run. It was really well done. And there's not much to say. I mean, this is just a very good run. You can always try it for yourself, either via emulator or on an actual Game Boy Color, whatever. But the community isn't that big. However, you can always make it bigger. There's a few people. There's about 5 of us on the leaderboard now. And, of course, if with just a bit of practice you could try and beat me, I think it's definitely possible. We've been discussing it, and under 14 minutes is certainly a possibility, especially since I lost time on new records screens, which is apparently about 3 seconds. So, that's about it. Yeah. Thanks for watching this video. Hope it wasn't too boring. Try and explain how this happened, and in case you're interested, you have some commentary behind it. And there you go. See you later now.